High-frequency indicators are helping track the health of the economy right now, and they're also being used by Wall Street forecasters to try and estimate tomorrow's monthly jobs report. Steve Leisman joins us with his road back barometer, and this is a biggie given what we heard from ADP the other day, Steve.
Yeah, exactly. ADP 15 years ago was the first of these, but it's a new world in economics, Becky, with forecasters using a host of real-time indicators in order to gauge the impact of the virus and the shutdown. Everything from credit card data that comes in just days after it's punched in to computers tracked work schedules for millions of employees. Now, those real-time indicators suggesting the strong job rebound in May and June may have given way to slowing and sharp slowing. While the consensus looks for 1.4 million job gains in July, some see the possibility of a decline in the real-time data as reported by the government tomorrow. Take a look at our three gauges that we're using. These are three of the most used data points on the street. The first one, starting on your left, Cronus there, which looks at hundreds of millions of time punches for shifts. It's showing growth in July of just 0.7%. In the middle is Homebase, which the St. Louis Fed just did a paper on and found it's one of the best indicators of the household survey. It is down 23.4% compared to January. And then the census now getting in, providing weekly data. And looking at the survey weeks, it's down a very sharp 4.7% compared to the survey week in June. Now, let's look at each one of these one by one, and we'll show you what the trajectory is of all of these. First of all, the home base. You can see the sharp increase it had from the bottom, which was in April. And now those two dips, by the way, are two holidays where fewer employees are being tracked by their scheduling software. And then it just goes flat, even dips down a little bit at the very end. Going on to Cronus, 2.7%, strong growth in May, 1.9%, strong growth in June. If you'd followed these indicators, you would have known what was going to go on with the jobs report, which surprised the street, but just 0.7% in July. And then here's the census data, which is interesting from two standpoints. First, you can see, again, the weekly data showing strong growth May to June, but 6.4 million fewer jobs registered from June to July. The good news in that survey is that tick up at the end, which doesn't include the survey week, but it shows that maybe we're getting a bit of a bounce back. Loretta Mester, president of the Cleveland Federal Reserve, yesterday saying it's worse than it may appear. As of mid-July, over half of district contacts have told us they are meaningfully altering their plans in response to the rise in virus cases. She said, including reducing employment or employee compensation or canceling or postponing planned capital expenditures. Over at Oxford Economics, Lydia Boussour writes, the July decline would underscore that the foundation to this recovery is cracking amid the recent surge in coronavirus cases nationwide. Just one more thing. There are seasonal adjustment issues that could push up the numbers tomorrow. Goldman's noted those. And no one has the silver bullet that's really figured out how to forecast jobs in this pandemic with millions of jobs lost and gained in between. But the indicators being used right now on the street, Becky, point to weakness.